We're here today with representatives from the Metropolitan Transportation Authority. I guess officially we last met about a year or so ago. Thank you again for coming and joining us. A lot of things have happened. We have a lot of opportunity to talk about some real substantive things today. Legislator Burton is here. Great, thank you, Bill. We have Hillary Ring, Director of Government Affairs for the MTA. Our board member, Mr. Cecil, Donald Cecil, and a neighbor of ours from Harrison is here. We have Mr. Johnson, is that correct, Doug?
Yeah, Douglas Johnson.
Doug, who is an efficiency matter, does not have a business card, which is great. Thank you for saving those dollars for us. And Mark Maddox, who is, what's your exact title, Mark?
Senior Director of Corporate and Public Affairs for Metro North Railroad.
Excellent, and a friend of this legislature for many, many years, and appreciate you gentlemen coming to us today. To my left is Legislator Bill Burton. To his left is Legislator Judy Myers, and then to her left is Legislator Pete Harcum, and possibly other legislators will be joining us as well. We now have a quorum, so we can even officially meet in that respect. This legislature is rightfully concerned about lots of issues, and rightfully concerned about the Metropolitan Transportation Authority. There have been a number of developments since we last were together, and look forward to hearing the big picture, but also having a chance to talk about the very important details, because the details is where much of this is at. You undoubtedly, gentlemen, have seen a resolution number 24-2010, which we passed unanimously. In fact, I came to your hearing recently, and Mr. Mannix and all, and presented it to the full board at that particular time, which resolved that we're urging the immediate repeal of the payroll tax that was recently authorized, resolving that we were asking for an independent forensic audit of the MTA to highlight ways to cut expenses, introduce budgetary efficiencies, and identify any potential fraud, mismanagement, and then resolved to thought it would be appropriate to look to other financial resources, such as federal stimulus dollars and other revenue sources, to be able to close the gap and be able to obviate the MTA tax itself. This is only one part of it. In fact, this is on the revenue side, and much of the time we spend here in this legislature is appropriately on the expenditure side. So we look forward to, again, hearing the big picture, but with your permission, would like to ask some questions, and myself and the members have prepared to really get a sense of what the picture is now and going forward.
Sure.
So with that said, I will turn it over to Mr. Ring.
And thank you again for inviting us to come. We were in the midst of working with Albany to try and come up with a funding package to so-called rescue the MTA. And at that time, the current Lieutenant Governor, Dick Ravitch, had chaired a commission, the Ravitch Commission, which recommended a series of things to finance the MTA, including a payroll tax in the region, and including bridge tolls in New York City, had a capital plan component, and the legislature spent many months debating this package. Finally, in May, the legislature adopted a package that had the payroll tax, as you mentioned. It had a series of other taxes, license fees in the New York region, auto registration increase, tax on auto rentals, and a surcharge on taxi cabs. And these revenues together were expected to yield about $1 billion in 2009 and $1.9 billion in 2010.
Had you taken any preemptive steps in the 2009 year in anticipation of revenue not being there?
No. In fact, the 2009 budget was built on the assumption of the Ravitch plan.
Right, but did you not, given the uncertain economic times, though, pull your belt in and try to spend only 95%, for example, of what you had budgeted, so that you'd have some play if revenue didn't come in as expected? Payroll was not guaranteed. It's based on an estimate, right?
It's based on an estimate. That's correct. That's why you can't bond it, for example,
right,
until there's a revenue.
Right. There's no certainty to it.
No, there's clearly some play, but the legislature in Albany determined that here's the financial package, mm-hmm, here's what we're comfortable financing, mm-hmm, and there was an agreement all around that this, right, is what the spending will be, these service cuts will come off the table, this is when fare increases will happen, and here's the hole that needs to be plugged, and here's how it's getting plugged.
Okay.
So we adopted a budget, and the board adopted a budget in December that essentially closed a $400 million gap. And the way we closed the gap was by doing the following things. We cut administrative payroll across the agencies by 10%. We're just implementing this now. We're actually cutting deeper. We're cutting administrative payrolls across all the agencies by 15%, and we're eliminating 20% of MTA headquarters. So that's a very significant reduction.
Non-represented.
Well, and represented. No, both.
The original plan was the 10% on
right.
the non-rep.
Mm-hmm. But the end of the day, the 15% and 20% cut that we're doing covers represented as well as non-represented.
So break down for, you said it was payroll side?
There's a 15% reduction in administrative payrolls.
And that's from overtime? That's just roll back
that's
on?
If you slice off the part of the payroll that is not involved in putting the service on the street.
Okay.
Or the rails.
Yep.
Everything that's left is administrative.
What percentage is administrative versus what you just described? 5%?
Or about 10% or something.
10%. So 10% of the workforce. And then the measures that you took within that, was it elimination of bonuses?
It's bodies out the door.
So layoffs.
There's going to be somewhere, depending on how many people accept the severance, somewhere around 500 layoffs.